Our word for this month is reward. And reward, that's a word that we love because it means most often that we're going to get something. And reward usually comes after we make some kind of diligent effort to do something for which somebody then wants to reward us. Well, I had a situation at home that made me think about that word a little bit differently. We had made, my daughter and I, that brave decision to adopt a little dog and as a puppy. We began to train him and to go through all of those tasks of the potty training and getting him to do the tricks. And with each time he did something that he was supposed to do, we rewarded him with a treat. Then one day my daughter's sitting there and she's doing some kind of iPodding or texting or Facebooking of some sort. And all of a sudden I hear her say, "Let me get you a treat." And of course I want to know, what is he being rewarded for? And I ask her, I said, "What did he do?" And she says, "He's just cute." And I thought to myself, oh my goodness, the horror. What is she doing rewarding him when he didn't do something for it? And then I got to thinking about that. How often in life do we have others that are just cute? They do things on a continuous basis for us. They offer their friendship and their support. And it's no big monumentous thing in the moment, but just on the daily ways that they add value to our life. We need to reward them as well, simply because they're cute, simply because they're kind, simply because they love us. So as we think about reward, make sure that you're taking time to give rewards to those around you every day for even the little things. I'm Kim Borelli, and it's been a pleasure to spend a moment with you thinking about the rewards.